Now let us see this topic, children. Subject verb agreement. Now what does it mean? It means it is an agreement between subject and verb. Means the correct use of verb according to the subject. If our subject is singular, we use singular verb. But if our subject is plural, we use plural verb. Now let us see worksheet number 1. Amit, Bobby, Charu and Divya have formed a book reading club. Now here there are 4 subjects: Amit, Bobby, Charu and Divya. There is more than one subject, so we use plural verb, that is have. You can see over here, these are the subject, there are 4, there are more than one, and so we are using the plural verb, that is have. Now next one, Amit, an architect and avid reader, is the founder of the club. Now in this sentence, what happens, children? Amit is the same person. Here Amit is singular, and so the word is. This is the singular verb. We use is. Why? Because architect and avid reader is used for Amit, and Amit is singular, and so a singular subject will be followed by singular verb. Every Saturday, all of them meet at his house and read for hours. Now all of them means everyone. It is a plural subject. So if the subject is plural, we will not use s in verb. Always remember, we will not use s in verb. If our subject is plural, we are not going to use s in the verb. At his house and read for hours. Each member brings one book and circulates it among the others. Now each member. When the words like each member, none of them, they are the singular subject. For this, we will be using singular verb. Each member brings. Each and none of them. It is a singular subject, and so we are using singular verb. In the previous sentence, I have told you that all of them, it is a plural subject. So plural, we are not going to use s in the verb. So we use s in the verb if it is singular subject. Because we consider each member and none of them as singular verb. I hope I am clear to you all. Now look, Amit likes to read books by Vikram Seth. Now again, Amit is singular and the verb that is followed is singular verb. It is always remember that S will be added. But neither Charu nor Divya has read any of his books yet. Again, when we use neither nor or either or. Neither nor or either or. We use verb according to the second subject. What is our second subject, children? Divya. So Divya is singular. And so we use has. This is the singular verb. But in the second case, you will see, this Saturday, either Charu or the two boys. So when either or neither nor. Look at this word, either or and neither nor. I told you it will depend, the verb will depend upon the second subject. In this sentence, second subject is Divya. So The verb is has, which is singular. But in this sentence, two boys, the second subject is two boys. It is plural. So we are using are. That is plural. Now look at this next sentence. Amit as well as his three friends thinks that reading is very rewarding habit. Now when in a sentence as well as is used, verb agrees to first subject like Amit, as well as when this word is used, the verb will be according to the first subject. First subject is Amit, which is singular, and so our verb is thinks. Thinks is again a singular subject. I told you that S will be followed. When our subject is singular, in the verb we will add S. Singular verb is used according to the first subject. Now look at this next sentence. He says, my three friends and I keep collecting different books. I have told you that my three friends and I, when more than one noun, three friends, it is more than one noun. So when more than one noun or pronoun are joined by and, pronouns are joined by and, we use plural verb. This is the plural verb where we are not going to add S. More than one noun is and a pronoun is joined by and, we will just see the first subject and we will use the verb in plural form. I hope you have understood, children, this much whatever I am trying to teach you. Now the next one, the majority of these books are by Indian authors. The majority of these books, again you will see that it is plural subject, so the verb is are. I hope you all know that is singular and are is plural. Has is singular, whereas have is plural. You can see here it is have because more than one subject. Here it is has because I have told you that in neither nor and either or, it will depend upon the second subject. Here the second subject is singular, so has, and here the second subject is plural, so are. When we use as well as in a sentence, then the subject, we have to look at the first subject and our verb will be according to that. That will be the singular verb and S will be added. In plural verbs, we don't add S. I hope this much is clear to you. Now, note, a finite verb always agrees with its subject in number and person. Now, what is a finite verb? I hope you all know about it, but still I will tell you. A finite verb can stand on its own. In a sentence, a verb that stands on its own, there is a single verb and it stands on its own, that type of verb is known as finite verb. Actually, that is the main verb. Okay, I keep collecting different books. It stands on its own. Keep. And it changes according to the number, person, and tense. The verb will change according to the tense. For example, I will tell you one sentence like, the thief escaped again. Look at this sentence. The thief escaped again. Now here the thief is the subject. Escaped is finite verb. It is telling you about the tense. Which tense? It is telling you about the past tense. And it is standing on its own. So, a finite verb changes according to the number, according to the person, and according to the tense. You can also see here, like things. Things can be changed into thought. Keep can be changed into kept. So this way, the finite verb change according to the tense and according to the person. Now look at this sentence. Air and water are necessary for survival. Manu and I were the host of the party. So I have already told you that when a noun and a pronoun are added by an, the verb will be plural. So Manu and I were the host of the party. Air and water are the necessary for survival. When the subject consists of two or more nouns or pronouns and is joined by and, plural verb is used. I think it is clear to you. When a noun or a pronoun is joined by and, a plural verb is used. Now with I, we use singular verb, but no S will be used. With you, we use plural verb. Again, there will be no S. He, she, it. We use singular verb. We will add S to the verb. Like she plays, she walks, he dances. We will add S in the verb. With we will use plural verb and there will be again no S. With you, when our subject is you, that is the plural subject, we will use plural verb but no S will be added. They, again, plural verb and no S will be added. These are some of the common rules of subject and how the verb will agree with the subject. Now see, children, some more rules of subject verb. Like if our subject is singular, we use singular verb. With that, we will use S and ES depending upon the subject. Plural subject, if we have got plural subject, the verb will be plural verb. Were, are, have, depends upon the subject. Then you is a plural subject, the verb will be again plural. If the each, neither, every, all these are singular subjects, and so these words will take singular verb.